Hi, my name is Ann Lee. I'm the Academic Advisor for Construction Engineering and Management at Virginia Tech, and I'm excited to get to talk with you a little bit today about the major here at Virginia Tech. To give you a little bit of background, Construction Engineering and Management is one of the College of Engineering major options. It's also part of the Myers-Lawson School of Construction, which is made up of Construction Engineering and Management majors, as well as building construction majors, and those majors fall under the College of Architecture and Urban Studies. You'll see that this is our building here, Bishop Favreau Hall, which houses both of those majors. And as I mentioned, I am the academic advisor. So if you have any questions after the presentation today, please feel free to reach out to me through email at annlee3@vt.edu. To give you a little background about the major, it's fairly new. It started in 2007, and it was created with the help of the industry. So what we heard from the industry is they wanted graduates who had a solid understanding of the business side of the construction industry, as well as management skills, people skills, combined with the knowledge and understanding of the structural design and the structural process of construction. And so that created this major, Construction Engineering and Management. So our students really take courses from three main areas on campus. The first is civil engineering. So our students take courses along with civil engineering majors, courses that are focused on the structural side of buildings. So you'll do intro to structural engineering, you'll learn about civil materials, you'll do a steel design course, you'll do a concrete class, you'll do a geotech course where you learn about the foundations, you'll do a measurements class where you learn about surveying. So all of those skills are giving you that solid understanding of structures and the building systems in progress. You'll also take courses from Construction Engineering and Management, and those are courses that have a little bit more of the business focus that goes along with the construction industry. So for example, courses include estimating and scheduling, where you figure out how much a project costs and how long it's going to take and all those steps in between. You'll also take construction economy, where you'll learn about accounting and finance, and you can actually create your own business plan, whether you plan to create your own business in the future or just to understand the process of creating a business plan. You'll take construction law and contract administration. You'll also do construction health and safety, which is definitely a part of every course that you're taking. But this specific course is really geared to help you think specifically about how you can keep your workers safe and healthy throughout the construction process. The other main area that courses our students take from are building construction courses. And so those courses include IT and design and construction, where you get to learn how to do 3D modeling of buildings. You'll also do a building systems class where you learn about the heating and cooling systems. You'll also do some integrated courses where you get to work as a subcontractor one semester for mechanical systems. The next semester you get to act as the general contractor. And so you're listening to the subcontractor's bids, and then you're also creating your own overview bid for the general construction projects. In addition to that, you'll do a two-semester sequence of capstone where you get to do a real-world scenario where you create the design for the project. You decide how long it's going to take and how much it's going to cost. You're also looking at how you're going to keep your employees safe throughout that process. And then you're also going to be looking at ways that it can be LEED certified so that you're making good decisions regarding the environment with the construction process. We also throw in a few business courses as well, and those courses are two economics courses and then one business elective as your choice. Typical jobs for our students after graduation include project manager or project engineer. That's where they're overseeing the entire construction process from the design all the way to the completed project and all of those steps in between. One of the things that I hear often from our students is that they love the variety of the job. They love knowing that they're not going to be in the office all day, and they love that it could be different every single day. So some days you might be on the job site, observing the work, seeing how things are progressing, helping with any problem solving that needs to happen. Other days you might be in the office doing more administrative type work where you're figuring out how much it's going to cost. Are you staying on track with that cost? What's the timeline looking like? Do you need to make adjustments? So it's really kind of a nice combination of options after graduation. If you decide you want to be on the job site all the time, you can pursue options as a superintendent. If you want to work more in the office, you could be a full-time estimator or a full-time scheduler. If you really like the 3D modeling aspect, you could pursue being a virtual design coordinator. And if you want to help create your own business or help create business for your company, you could also become a business developer. Because this is a major within the College of Engineering, students can also pursue their professional engineering license. So that starts with taking a Fundamentals of Engineering exam your senior year, working with a professional engineer for 3 to 5 years, and then going on and taking your professional engineering exam. If you pass that, you are licensed, and at that point, you can actually create the structural designs for buildings if you'd like to. You can also review those structural designs and put your stamp on it. Right now is a great time to be in the construction industry. Our students have 100% job placement. Most have 2 to 4 job offers, and the starting salary on average is $66,000. What we've heard from the industry is that they like our students, they just need more of them. We're actually trying to double in size within the next 5 years so that we can start better meeting the demand for the workers in the construction industry. To help with this, we offer 2 career fairs each year, one in the fall, one in the spring. Those are geared specifically to the Myers-Lawson School of Construction, so both construction engineering and management majors, as well as building construction majors. Those employers are looking for summer paid interns, as well as full-time employment. So if coming into Virginia Tech as a general engineering major your first year, if you know construction engineering and management is the route you would like to go, you are welcome to come to our career fair and try and get an internship after your very first year at Virginia Tech. We encourage you to get internships as soon as you can and as many as you can. Not only does that give you good experience and helps you try out different options and see what's going to be a good fit for you after graduation, it also helps you to start making those connections within the industry, which as you get into the industry, you'll see how small it is and how everyone really does know one another. So after the session today, we will have individual chatting available from 9:40 to 11:40. I will be available as well as some of our students. So Reed and Young are both seniors in the CEM major, and Emmy is a sophomore. So they will also be available if you'd like to get the student perspective. I do want to briefly highlight a few items on our website that you can go back and look at in further detail after today and as you're maybe processing everything if you have new questions. So the first thing I want to highlight is the people section. You can look up our faculty and staff, but you can also go to the ambassador page. And this is all of our current ambassadors are current students in the CEM major. They love the major, they love talking about the major, and they want to help more students know about the major. So you can click on any student. So for example, Reed is going to be one of the students you can chat with later today. You can see what year he is in school, where he's from, a little bit about him, and then you can email him directly. So again, if after today you want to hear from current students, please reach out to our ambassadors. They would be happy to talk with you. The other item I want to go to is under advising. If you click on prospective students, this is a great page for you as you're thinking about Virginia Tech and as you're thinking about construction engineering and management. So again, it gives you a little more background about the major. You can go to the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics to find out more as well. If you want to hear from current students, we do have a few videos from our spring 2019 graduates, so you can hear about what their experience was as a student in the CEM major. You can also learn more about what the industry is saying. There's a nice video on here from our fall 2017 career fair, so you can see what that looks like. You also get to hear from students. You get to hear from the director of our program, as well as people from the industry who are there trying to find workers. As I mentioned before, here's all my contact info. So if you want to reach out with any questions, please feel free to do that. There's three more items I want to highlight. The first is the CEM program brochure. It gives you a general overview about the major. It gives you some student feedback. It also talks about student organizations. So there's opportunities to get involved as a student when you're in the major as well. There's also a day in the life of a CEM graduate, and this brochure I think is really helpful to see what you can do with your degree after graduation. So it gives you the names of our recent graduates, their job title and where they're working. It gives you their major job responsibilities, what a typical day looks like for them, what they like best about their position, and then how the CEM major helped prepare them for their current position. The final item I want to highlight is our CEM 2022 check sheet, and this is the draft. It is actually in the process right now of being approved. It just needs to get the final stamp on it, so it has gone through all the proper channels, but we wanted to leave the draft on there until we officially have that stamp on there. But this is basically the four-year plan. It lists all the courses that you would take throughout your time in the CEM major, semester by semester. So I just wanted to highlight briefly up here, this is for students entering the university in the year 2020. So that applies to all of you watching this video right now. It's a grand total of 130 credit hours. You can see semester by semester, that averages to be around 16 credit hours. The coloring on here, the beige color is for all the pathways courses, which are those general education requirements required of all students. And then the green color is for courses that are critical to the major. So the first year, you'll be a general engineering major. You'll complete these courses. And at the end of that first year is when you'll apply to your specific option within the College of Engineering. So if that choice is construction engineering and management, you would start that your sophomore year. So just to briefly highlight how we talked about you take courses from different areas on campus. When you see CEM, those are construction engineering and management courses. When you see CEE, those are the civil engineering courses. And when you see BC, those are the building construction courses. If you scroll down further, you can actually see the breakdown of the pathways courses. Again, most of these are designated because they actually overlap with your major. The areas that are not designated is just where you get to pick and choose the courses that would interest you. Some of you may be coming in with AP credit or dual credit, and so sometimes that's where you can see those credits show up. This is also where you can review the business electives and then the engineering electives. So that is my quick overview of construction engineering and management at Virginia Tech. Thank you so much for your interest. Again, if you have questions, please feel free to chat with us after the session or feel free to email me or any of the ambassadors as well. So good luck in your decision, and we hope to see you here in the fall. Thank you.